I have decided to give you an answer to the question that I posted on my Facebook via this audio, because if I were to write it, it would be so lengthy. So I think the best way to do it is by sending you the audio. But this is in reference to the Facebook question that I posted, and you responded to know more. So the question is, have you ever wondered why men and women prior to marriage seem to live together for many years, and as soon as they marry, it's as though like hell breaks loose, and they only live together for a short period of time, then they break up? And you know, dear heart, I also throughout my life have noticed this about several people, and especially an aunt of mine. She's the first one I ever noticed where she had lived prior to marriage with her husband for 8 long years. Then they decide to marry, and lo and behold, right after they marry, he went into another relationship with a woman, ended up leaving her, being married less than a year. And I just thought as a teenager that was so strange. But now, coming to the knowledge of Jesus Christ, you know, the wisdom in his word and the Holy Spirit raising me and teaching me and showing me different things in his word, and just opened up my understanding where I can see more clearly, I finally see the picture now. And this is the problem. The problem is, first of all, demons. People, a lot of times people don't know what actually demons are. Demons are really personalities. It is a spirit being that do not have a body, and it's their personality. So their desire is to find a host, a body where they can express themselves, because they're not legally can be in this earth realm. The earth realm is only for we human beings as well as the Holy Spirit. We are legally here by the authority of God. With demons, they and Satan as well, they are not legally here. If they are here, they are here illegally, where they have, you know, deceived someone, and they hear by that way. But you can't see them with your natural eye. So that's the reason why they want a body, you know, and they want, you know, to be in someone's soul, which is their mind, their will, and emotion, so they can express themselves. You know, just like the Holy Spirit, we can't see him, but how he expresses himself is through us. Because as we receive Jesus into our heart, the Holy Spirit comes within our spirit, and he makes his abode. And our body is his temple. It's his temple, not the temple for demon spirit to express their personality. And there's so many of them, I don't know, millions of them with different personalities, terrible, evil personalities. That's the reason why you see some people who are, you know, mentally, we say mentally retarded. Really, that is actually demons that have possessed not only their body and their soul, but their spirit as well. And that demon have taken up complete control of that person. So they are expressing themselves. And you have seen some human beings who we say are mentally retarded, they do some silly stuff. You know, their personality is just foolish. Well, that is really the personality of demons, because that's what demons are. They are personalities. They are evil personalities. Twicked, they're wicked. So anyway, getting to our answer to our question, why it seems like a man and woman proud to marry live together for many years, and then soon after they marry, you know, it's like they don't stay together long, because, I mean, they even make the comment, we got along much better when we weren't married. Then when we got married, we should have never got married. Now, dear heart, the reason for that is this. First of all, marriage is from God. And remember that Satan and the wicked angels used to be where God is now. But because of his his Satan, or at that time he was Lucifer, he had his own will, and he wanted to he really wanted the worship that God was receiving, and then he got, you know, those one third of angels to back him up and to see from his point of view, and the Lord just didn't stand for it, and he kicked them out of heaven, and he landed here on earth. So we have to remember that Satan hates God with a passion. He tremendously hates God. So the scripture indicates in Genesis that man was created in the image and likeness of God. So every time Satan and his wicked angel and the demons out. Now, I really don't have a clear understanding on how demons got on this earth, because they are not angels. They are not the angels that was cast down from heaven with Lucifer. So that you have to get that knowledge from another man or woman of God, because I'm not clear on how those demons, which are those personalities, wicked personalities that don't have bodies, got to be on this earth. I'm not sure, so I can't give you any detail on that. All I know is that they are here. So you have to remember, since we, man, male and female, we was made in the image and likeness of God, that every time Satan and his cohort hosts, all of his wicked followers, including those fallen angels, including demons, because they linked up with Satan because they got the same purpose. They want to overthrow God. They hate God. So you have to remember now, since we're made in the image likeness of God, according to Genesis 1:27, they hate us, because every time they look at us, guess who they're reminded of? They are reminded of God. So they hate us with a passion. So just like their leader, Satan, who only purpose is to kill, to steal, and to destroy, that's what they want to do. So again, the reason why a man or woman prior to marriage seems to get along much better and that relationship seems to last longer is because they are already on Satan's team. Because number one, they fail to honor God and to respect God through marriage. Because according to Hebrews 13 chapter verse 4, and I'm reading from the Complete Jewish Bible, it says marriage is honorable in every respect. So marriage is respectable, it's proper, it's right, it's good, and it's good, and it's praiseworthy. And in particular, sex within marriage is pure. So sex outside of marriage is impure and it's unholy. So in other words, when that couple is living together without being married, they are already on Satan's team. And remember what the Lord said? The Lord said Satan does not tear down or come against his own kingdom. He do not do that. So that's the reason why it seems like they're getting along so well. Why? Because the difference between the Lord and Satan is that the Lord would not force you to submit your will to him when Satan will. So if we choose to disobey God, then God is not going to force us to obey him. He's not going to send his angel to bang us over the head to make us, submit and obeying him. He let it be our choice, and we just have to suffer the consequences. Well, Satan, on the other hand, is not like that. When we submit to God in every area of our life, Satan ain't going to say, well, that's their choice, they got their free will. No, he's going to force himself on you by forcing you to submit your will to him, because he's a dictator. And that's what a dictator does. A dictator forces you to submit your will to his or her leadership. Satan is the greatest dictator. So when two people, male and female, are not married and choose to live together and disrespect God by disrespecting marriage, because the only way that they can show respect toward God is through marriage, then they have no problem with Satan. None whatsoever. Satan is not come against them. Why? Because Satan already have them in his cage. In his cage. Okay? And because of being disobedient unto the Lord in that area and not marrying, then what the two people are not realizing, every demonic entity or personality that is roaming this earth, it will find an occasion to enter them. And the main spirits that will enter that man and that woman who have failed to marry is the demon spirit of lust, the demon spirit of anger. And remember now, every demon spirit is attached to another demon spirit, because in the kingdom of darkness, you have demon spirits that are considered to be the strong man, and he have lesser spirits serving under him. So in a relationship where two people are living together outside, you know, and they're not married, come together and sin against their body, because by the way, the word of God states that every sin we commit is not against the body. Only one sin that we commit that is against the body, and that is fornication or adultery. That's having sex, you know, outside of marriage. That's when we sin against our body. So again, because of those of the man and the woman living in that adulterous fornicated relationship, they are already in the kingdom of darkness. So therefore, they don't have the opposition, who is Satan, the opposer, coming against them, because they walking in his will. As a matter of fact, he'll make things go smoothly so you can continue to live in that lifestyle. Now, he's going to hide from you what the consequences is going to end up being, which is death. Because spiritually speaking, when you outside of the will of God, disobeying him, there's a spiritual death that immediately takes place. And if you keep being disobedient, as time move on, physically a death will take place. And then when your soul wakes up, you'll wake up in hell where you're burning for eternity. And them same demon personality that was with you on earth going to be the very one that's going to torment you in hell. See, Satan blinds that from the individual. And then the case where maybe they say, you know what, let's get married. And they finally get married. Well, when they get married now, when the two get married, they still may not have submitted their life to Jesus, but the fact that they marry is a disgrace to Satan, because when you marry, you are giving respect to God. Because again, the Lord said marriage is honorable in every respect, and the bed is undefiled. So when you decide to marry, you automatically become an enemy of Satan, because marriage was ordained by God. And you are saying, Lord, I'm respecting you because I'm choosing to marry. And Satan like, oh no, I don't like that. And he become angry and he lashes out. So the demons now that you got to deal with now, when you got married, it's going to call forth for a stronger demon, which is a stronghold, and that is what you call a spirit husband or a spirit wife. If you're a man, it's a spirit wife. If you're a wife, if you're a woman, it's a spirit husband. And what this spirit husband, spirit wife does, they themselves claim you as their husband and as their wife. Remember, it's a demon personality. It's an evil, twisted personality that claims you as their husband or their wife. And so when you marry, they know that illegally they are not your husband, not your wife. So when you marry that man and you marry that woman, if you are a man, then the spirit wife becomes so angry because it now feels that it's still your wife, but you are chosen in this natural realm to marry a woman. And so now the spirit wife is going to do everything in her power to break up you from your wife. And that spirit wife will work through you. And if you are a woman, the spirit husband is working through you to come against your physical husband. And then if you are a man, the spirit wife through you is coming against the physical wife to break up your marriage. So it will cause every problem that it can cause to divide and to separate you from your husband and you from your wife. Why? Because you chose to honor God and respect God through and by marriage. Because remember now, Satan will force you to submit your will to him when you're not in his kingdom. Because again, when you choose to marry, you are honoring God. And anytime we honor God, it makes the evil one very, very angry. And he comes against you. So that's the reason why a man can live with a woman outside of marriage for a long time, for many years, and it seems like things are going fine. And then soon as they get married, it's like hell break loose, and they only live together for a short period. They break up. It's because of the demon personalities of spirit husband and spirit wife. That's the reason why you find a lot of Christian families where the husband and wife are breaking up. Why? Because they're coming against the wrong husband, coming against the wrong wife. Instead of coming against their physical wife or physical husband, no, instead of coming against their spirit husband and spirit wife, they come against the physical husband and physical wife. Because when that spirit husband and spirit wife is working through them and in them, the physical husband and wife is not even aware. They don't even know what's going on. But for instance, let's choose the physical wife who has a spirit husband. Well, she may do things or say things against her physical husband, and the husband look at her like, why do you say that? And she like, what did I say? And he said, well, you said such and such. She said, well, I didn't say. And he said, I know you did say it because I heard you. And she said, baby, I didn't say that. What you trying to say, I'm crazy? No, you're not crazy. She's not crazy. It was that spirit husband who is in the woman. You see, dear heart, that's the reason why before two people get married, you know, we have been taught before two people get married, they need counseling. Dear heart, we kind of got it wrong there. Before two people get married, and I've been married 26 years now, and Lord, and I thank him for his forgiveness between me and my husband, but I praise him and thank him for the light that he has given me and reference to some things and regarding his word. But before two people get married, they first need deliverance. They need deliverance. Then once you are delivered, then you can do some counseling. Because if you try to counsel one prior to deliverance, it ain't going to work. I'm going to give you a perfect example. I'm going to use my lifestyle. And I know my husband doesn't mind me telling you about this because, you know, we praise God and thank God that he has forgiven both of us and I have forgiven him. And now we use our testimony to the glory of God in helping others. But I'm going to give you a perfect example as far as before you get married, or even right after you get married, where a lot of time counseling is not working. You need deliverance first. Right after my husband got married, my husband and I got married, and I think probably it was about eight years, I believe. Five years into our marriage. Yeah, 5 years. Because at that time, our third daughter was just born, and my baby was three. I think I'm going to make sure I get this right. No, I think it was 3 years. It was 3 years after our marriage. Anyway, 3 or 5, I can't seem to remember, 3 or 5 years. But anyway, we were having such a difficult time. It was problem behind problem in this church we were going to at the time. I'm not going to call it the name of the church. But we were having so much, many problems. I just couldn't understand, you know, before we got married, we just loved each other and got along fine. Even right after we got married, the first 2 years was great. Roger was very understanding. We got along real good. He loved me very well. And so it was three. Now, no, it was 3 years after our marriage. So anyway, right after around the third year of our marriage, we started having a lot of problems. And he seemed to be, you know, just pop attitudes at me all the time. And you know, after having a baby, I put on a little weight. I just wasn't looking as slim and attractive like I was in the beginning. And that had a problem. It went in his mind. But first of all, when we got married, it wasn't through love. It was through lust. I'll be quite honest with you. But anyway, so, you know, Roger, you know, now, he was still going to church. When he would go to church, he seemed to be a totally different man. He seemed to be a man who loved his wife and loved his kids. But at home, he was totally different. A lot of you men hearing me, you do the same thing. And I know there's some women who do it too. But the Lord get on the men, because the man is supposed to be the head of the home. He's supposed to be the priest of the home. But anyway, but I'm just telling you about my husband now. And I was, you know, I loved being at home. He never had a word about having a wife, you know, wasn't, you know, satisfied being at home with her children. He never worried about that. He didn't really have to worry about a wife who held against him. He couldn't give me things that I needed, you know, let alone things that I wanted, you know. But I was very understanding, you know, because that's the way my mother raised me. But anyway, because of him not being where he should be in the Lord, and because I was not where I should be in the Lord, and because the church that we attend weren't where they should have been in the Lord, including the pastor and the leadership. So anyway, at that moment we're having a problem, you know, he still went to church, and at that time went to church on Saturdays, and I saw the fakeness and the phoniness in him. So I said, you know what, I'm not going to church with him, because he's just making the pastor think that he's doing stuff right, and because he committed and going to services every week, and the pastor think that he's an all right man, when I ain't going to go to church, because I ain't going to sit there and watch him being phony. So I wouldn't go to church. So by not going to church, so you know, that made it look like I was the wrong one. So anyway, we were still having problems. So finally, I said, you know what, maybe we should counsel with the pastor. Because then they always talked about counseling, you know, newly married couple. Couldn't find out now that older married couple need just as much counseling as a newly married couple. So anyway, the pastor and assistant pastor came over. And I noticed that Roger got real quiet. He wouldn't say a word. I thought Roger would open up and to share how he felt and stuff, but he wouldn't say a word. He got quiet. Well, I did all the talking. You know, I was telling, pointing out my heart and everything, and I, you know, I was telling about what was going on, and then that pastor looked at me and said, Terry, you the problem. I'm like, huh? And he said, you the problem, and I need to do this, and I need to do that. And I'm still looking at Roger, and he's sitting there just as quiet, wouldn't say a word. He was so humble-looking, appearing. I mean, the perfect picture of being humble. And I was saying in my mind, you know what? I'd be glad when you two get out of my house. Because we was about to move to another location, and I needed to pack. And I was like, that man was talking. He just blamed me for everything. But I praise and thank God that God gave me strength to endure and bear that. And I was saying to myself, when I get you out of my house, I would never, ever counsel with you again. Because all they did was took sides with Roger, didn't question Roger, and asked him no question or nothing. They just because he went to church every Saturday faithfully, they looked at that there was nothing wrong with Roger. And because they didn't see me, they judged me as if I was the wrong one. So anyway, they left. Well, lo and behold, now I didn't find this out until, Lord allowed me to find this out until the 10th year of our marriage. And the 10th year of our marriage, then that's when I put one and one together as for why Roger was so quiet over there. Well, the 10th year of our marriage, and I'm not going into details, was that I found out he was unfaithful to me. And when I rewinded to the time, it was right at that time that we counseled with the leadership regarding our marriage. He knew all the while when he was sitting there that he had that he was in an adulterous relationship and did not give no hint or clue to no one that he was having an affair. And that what was the problem. The problem was a spirit wife. A spirit wife. And that spirit wife in him was coming against me, his natural wife, and trying to get him through this woman to leave his wife and his family. And he needed deliverance. And also, I needed deliverance because I was angry, too, because of the way that he was behaving. So, the point I'm trying to get you see how that counseling didn't do no good? No, here my husband and I sitting up there, we both needed deliverance. We needed demon spirits cast out of us because years later, the Lord did cast a demon spirit out of me. But the point of this is that counseling didn't work. Why? Because we needed deliverance. So if you understand my voice, and you aren't married, or if you are married, and especially if your husband and wife have been married before, I don't care how godly they may seem to be, and they've been married before, or if they have not, you need to ask the Lord to reveal to you if any hidden evil personality that may have leached itself to you during the process of time and get delivered. Then you can be counseled. Husband and wife having a problem, deliverance. Then be counseled. Not counseling and delivering. Because I'm telling you, we got counseled, and when they left, we were still the same. But I praise God, thank God his mercy and grace years later set us free. And we got delivered. Dear heart, I tell you, again, the Lord said marriage is honorable in every respect. In particular, sex within marriage is pure. But God himself will indeed punish fornicators and adulterers. Praise the living God. So, dear heart, I hope that answered your question. That is really the answer. Is spirit husband and spirit wife. They hate marriage. Marriage between a physical man and a physical woman. Because it gives God respect and it gives God glory. And so when we choose to respect God in any area of our life, those demons as well as Satan comes against us. And that's why it's very important, we who are married, that we continue to submit to God and ask the Holy Spirit to reveal to us any unclean thing that may be within us. Don't just assume that you're okay. Don't just assume your wife is okay just because she can preach the gospel, just because he can preach the gospel. Don't just assume they're okay, dear heart. Don't just assume that. Because you don't know what spirits they picked up before they married you. Before they married you. A lot of time, men and women, especially if you're their second spouse, they have picked up some type of demon spirit before they met you. And especially lust. A lot of times they get married because they feel, well, I just got to marry because, I can't do without sex. I just can't do without sex. It's good that they want to marry, but getting married just to have sex shouldn't be the reason why you marry. That means, could it be lust maybe in there somewhere? Come on, dear heart. We need to think. And just because you get married doesn't mean the demon spirit of lust has been cast out. No. I know some testimonies on that. I know there's some of you that say, husband, wife, they can't lust against each other. They can't lust for one another. Dear Lord, I can give you some testimonies here. If that's the case, then while some husband and wife is having or sex, what do you call or sex if that's not lust? Do you think God was the one who created or sex? No, the mouth was not designed for a woman to be putting her husband's penis in his mouth, and a woman's vagina was not designed for the husband to be putting his lips in it. That is not of God. That is a demon spirit. Why do you think just because you marry, that gives you the right to do any and every type of ungodly act in your bedroom? Do you not know that demon will be right there present with you in your bedroom? They're the one who's whispering in your ear to commit such acts between you and your spouse. That is not God. And that is not love. That is lust. Come on now, dear heart. Come on now. That is not God. That is lust. And you need to repent and sin no more. Repent and sin no more. Why do you think that so many husbands and wives who start out doing such acts, and then eventually they get tired, and that same demon, which is spirit husband, spirit wife, whispering in their ears and want to try something different. Baby, how do you feel about a threesome? Come on now. We need to get wise here. We need to get wise. Marriage does not allow us to do every in any and every evil thing or act that we want to do in our bedroom just because we husband, wife, and we think God will be pleased with it. No, dear heart. Demons can be right there present in your bedroom being a husband and wife if you allow them to. If you allow them to. So again, dear heart, I wanted to do this audio because if I have written it out, it just been too much writing. And I wanted just to share that with you since you happen to be one of those who say, you know what, I want to hear more, Miss King, on what you have to say about the matter. And really, it's not what I have to say about the matter, what God have shown me throughout the years through experiences and of my personal experiences of others. And also what the Holy Spirit has been teaching and showing me. Because I'm telling you, you will absolutely be surprised at so much evil going on in the privacy of a husband and wife bedroom. And they all count it towards the glory of God. But yet and still, their family, their house is in disarray. Look at the children. Perfect example, let you know that is not the Holy Spirit. Look at your children. Your children also walking in fornication. Those of you who do have children, being disobedient. Things ain't working out on your job, and you're wondering why. Especially you men, things not working out on your job, that is a spirit husband that's coming against you because he don't want you to be successful. And then it'll whisper in your ear, well, it's fine as long as your wife got the good job. No. You're the one who's supposed to have the good job. Anybody who got the good job, it should be the husband. He's the one who's the head of the house. He's the one who set the example, not the wife. So if the wife been blessed and the husband's not, that is a perfect clue that there is a spirit husband working behind the scene against the husband. Now, don't look at the wife. Remember what Paul said, the battle is not against flesh and blood. Your physical wife is not your problem. It's that spirit husband. And you need to open up your mouth and cast it out in Jesus' name. Tell it to get out. Come out of your wife in Jesus' name. Praise the living God. And the same thing is true about the physical wife. You know, it's like you're watching your husband and it seems like he don't really, is not attracted to you like he used to be. He seems not to be loving you like he used to be. He gets in the bed, he turns on his side, and he just don't touch you. You need to come against that spirit wife that is working in him. Cast it out in Jesus' name. Stop divorcing the physical wife or the physical husband and divorce, which is separate from the spirit wife and the spirit husband who is doing the work behind the scene. And it only can be done through faith in Jesus Christ by the power of the Holy Spirit. Praise the living God. So, dear heart, thank you for being one of the few that wanted to hear the answer to that question. And feel free to meditate on it and ask the Holy Spirit to give you more understanding of it. And he will enlighten your understanding. And I praise God and thank him. And, you know, if you want to hear more about it from my husband's point of view, you know, feel free. He's on Facebook as well, Roger D. King. Feel free to send him a private message, and he, too, will be glad to talk with you as well. Again, thank you. And remember, as always, in your getting, get understanding. Shalom.